Hello, today is Sunday, June 22nd. This presentation will look back to the temperature and precipitation numbers for the month of June so far. Then we will look ahead to the Climate Prediction Center's outlook for the summer season and a broad outlook for the remainder of the year. Here is a monthly summary of precipitation and temperatures at area airports for the month of June through the 21st. In the top portion of the slide, you can see precipitation values for area airports with departure from normal values in parentheses. All airports reported below normal precipitation. The southern airports of Canyonlands, Montrose, and Durango only recorded a trace of rain for the month so far. Most of the rainfall recorded at the other airports fell on Sunday, June the 8th. The bottom portion of the slide shows that June temperatures were generally warmer than normal except at Grand Junction and Craig that have been quite cool. Grand Junction, for instance, had only 4 days into the lower 90s so far this year, as of June 21st. The current forecast models produce above normal temperatures for the remainder of the month, with Grand Junction in the low to mid 90s. Here are annual precipitation graphs for three representative sites in this forecast area: Vernal in northeast Utah, Grand Junction in west central Colorado, and Cortez in southwest Colorado. For most of eastern Utah and western Colorado, June is the driest month of the year before the effects of the monsoon season that typically starts in July, circled here. Again, June 2014 has been even drier than normal. This dry pattern looks to persist into the first week of July. The most powerful tool for seasonal outlooks is the El Niño Southern Oscillation, or ENSO for short. In the equatorial eastern Pacific between the dateline and the coast of Ecuador is the Niño 3.4 region outlined here by the red box. Warmer than normal temperatures began to develop in this Niño 3.4 region in May and has continued to warm into June. This slide shows the mid-June forecast from numerous models of how sea surface temperatures in the Niño 3.4 region will vary from normal through the summer, fall, and early winter of 2014, from left to right across the graph. You can see all but one of the forecast lines are above the 0.0 level, indicating developing warmer waters. Most of the models warm into the El Niño category sometime this late summer or fall. Whether this will be a weak, moderate, or strong El Niño is much less certain, but a moderate El Niño is the best forecast for now. Shifting now to the forecast, here is the National Climate Prediction Center's outlook for the month of July. The temperature outlook chart on the left shows no forecast skill, with this forecast area in the white EC area representing equal chances of above, near, or below normal temperatures. The right chart shows a shift of probabilities towards a wetter than normal summer season, with most of that wetter signal to the north of our forecast area. Thus, this is not a result of monsoonal moisture working up from the south. Indeed, forecast models as of today, June 22nd, indicate hot and dry will continue through the first week of July. Here is the National Climate Prediction Center's outlook for the three-month season of July, August, and September. The temperature outlook chart on the left shows a trend towards cooler than normal conditions only in northwest Colorado, with no forecast skill elsewhere. The right precipitation chart continues to show a shift of probabilities towards a wetter than normal season. Here again are annual precipitation graphs in dashed black for Vernal, Grand Junction, and Cortez. The red line is the precipitation average of all 18 El Niño seasons since 1950. You can see that during El Niño years, the month of July tends to have wetter than normal conditions develop in Cortez, while Grand Junction and Vernal tend to be drier than normal. For August into September, all three sites show a tendency towards wetter than normal conditions. This forecast has some implications for the Four Corners region, where moderate drought continues at this time. Of the 18 El Niño seasons since 1950, four El Niños have occurred within the last 15 years. The most recent, in 2009-10, was strong. 2006-07 and 2002-03 were moderate, and 2004-05 was a weak El Niño. This subset of the most recent El Niño shows a tendency for a dry summer and a wet fall. The four winters, shown here, tended to be drier than normal, with some periods of good snowfall showing up within only one of the winter months. This concludes this June climate summary and seasonal outlook. The next outlook will be produced in late July. You can follow the National Weather Service in Grand Junction on our website at www.weather.gov/GJT or on Facebook or Twitter. Thank you for listening and have a great summer.